be making mittens.
The materials that you'll need for this project are a sweater that is 100% wool, thread to match the sweater, different colored wool fibers, felting needles, and a felting mat or a foam pad.
We're going to start by felting the sweater, which is not difficult at all. All you need is a washing machine and a dryer.
Let's go see if we can shrink this sweater.
Put the sweater into the clothes washer. Make sure the temperature is on hot wash, cold rinse, and it's on regular cycle. Once the wash basin is full of water, add some detergent and let the washer do the rest for you. Once the sweater is done washing, take it out and place it in the dryer. Turn the temperature to high heat. Turn the dryer on and let it finish shrinking your sweater. Now the sweater is dry. Let's see if it shrunk. It looks perfect. Now let's make some mittens. After your sweater has been washed, dried, and shrunk, you're ready to get started. As you can see on the mittens that I've already made, I've used the bottom hem of the sweater for the hem around the arm of the mitten. Start by deciding how long you want your mittens to be. Basically, the hem of your sweater should be where you want the mitten to end on your arm. I'm going to make a long pair of mittens. So I'll place my arm on the sweater with the hem at my elbow. Then I'll draw a mark on the sweater about half an inch past my fingertips. Now I'm going to fold the side of the sweater over and place my hand on top. I want the material to extend about an inch past my open thumb. Then I'm going to mark where the material stops right here. Now I'll open the sweater up and with a ruler draw in my line based on the marks that I've made. Now cut out your square of material. At this point, you're going to open up your rectangle and cut it along the side seam of the sweater. Now you've got two squares, one for each mitten. Now we get to do one of my very favorite things, needle felting. You don't have to needle felt your mittens if you don't want to, but I'm going to because it's so much fun. Do you know the difference between a regular needle and a felting needle? A regular needle is perfectly smooth with a hole at the end. A felting needle has little barbs on the end to help felt your wool fibers together. The barbs are very sharp, so be very careful with your fingers. I learned that lesson the hard way. I've got several colors of wool fibers here, and even some wool yarn if I decide to use it. I've got a foam pad, and I've placed my two squares of wool sweater laid out on top of it. You can use a regular pillow if you don't have a foam pad. Needle felting is simple. You just place your wool fibers or yarn on top of your wool material and poke, poke, poke until they're stuck together. I'm going to needle felt some lines on the top of my mittens for decoration. To make simple lines, pull a thin strip of wool fiber off of your desired color. It's best to pull them apart, not to cut it. Place your wool fibers in the place where you'd like it and start needle felting around a place near the end. I like to use two needles. I place one needle where I'd like the line to end, and then I curl the wool fibers around the needle to make a nice end, and then I needle felt it there. Take your second needle out and start needle felting that end down very tightly. I've turned my piece around and pinned the end of my line to the foam to keep it in place. Now I'll gently pull on the fibers to keep the line straight, and then I'm going to keep on needle felting. I'll repeat these steps till all of my lines are finished. One thing I'd like to say is to pull up your material every once in a while to release the fibers from your foam mat. This allows more fibers room to bond to each other. So give it a pull, then continue needle felting. Finished my needle felting. As you can see, the lines that I felted on are symmetrical, so when I make the mittens, the lines will be the same. Now I'll peel the pieces off of the foam. If you look on the back of your piece of fabric, you can see where the pieces of fiber came through. Now give each of the lines a tug. If they pull away from the sweater material, then continue needle felting them. If they hold tight, then you've done enough. Now fold each of the pieces of fabric in half so the back side of the fabric is up. Place the outer edge of your pinky and the outside of your arm along the folded edge of the fabric. Keep your thumb open. Draw around your hand and your thumb. When you're done, your pieces of fabric should look like this. At this point, I'm going to pin the fabric together to keep it in place while I'm sewing. Now, with your sewing machine, sew over the lines you drew. When you get to the inside point of your thumb, make sure your needle is down, lift the presser foot, and then turn it to follow your line. Now I've taken out my pins and I'm going to cut around the sewn edge, leaving a quarter of an inch of fabric. At this point, you can turn your mittens and try them on, but I'm going to finish the edge so it doesn't fray. Now do a zigzag stitch over your cut edge and you'll be finished. Now that I've done the zigzag stitch all the way around my cut edge, all I need to do is turn them and I'll be finished. My mittens are now finished, and I'm ready to go outside in the cold weather and play. See you next time!